In today's show, this trader who successfully called the Bitcoin crash says that this altcoin in particular can surge 22,900% and predicts the Bitcoin price burst to $115,000. We're talking about Dave the Wave. He now expects Bitcoin to launch a vertical ascent to $24,000 in the coming months. And he goes on to share, the breakout from this pattern could ignite a manic phase that could catapult the Bitcoin price to $115,000. I'll be breaking down this technical analysis and bullish price predictions for you right here in today's show. Also, in today's episode, major breaking news, MicroStrategy, a NASDAQ-listed software firm worth $1.2 billion and publicly traded, has bought $250 million worth of Bitcoin as a reasonable hedge against inflation. In today's show, I'm going to be sharing with you three reasons why this company, MicroStrategy, adopted Bitcoin and why others will follow suit. Also, in today's episode, Grayscale launches their new crypto ad on national TV highlighting Bitcoin and eight altcoins. I'm going to be premiering these 30-second TV ads for you right here in today's show. Also, in today's episode, this new crypto asset skyrockets 1,880% on launch day. I'm going to be sharing why traders are pouncing on this particular altcoin. We're also going to be taking a look at the overall crypto market. As you can see, the king of all crypto back in the red. Many of the altcoins also in the red, but where's the Bitcoin price likely to go from here? Find out all this, plus so much more in today's show. Here at Crypto News Alerts, I drop a brand new episode every single day. So be sure to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts just like this. And before we kick off today's show, if interested in tapping into OPM and leveraging other people's money to grow your wealth and crypto portfolio, smash the link right below this video in the description. All right, welcome back to another episode of Crypto News Alerts. I'm your host, JV, and let's kick it off by diving into today's top story of the day. Lots to discuss, lots happening in the crypto market. Trader who called the Bitcoin crash says this altcoin can surge 22,000% and predicts the Bitcoin price burst to $115,000. Let's break it down. A crypto trader and strategist who accurately predicted last year's Bitcoin crash says one altcoin that was hammered during the brutal bear market has massive upside potential. The pseudonymous trader strategist Dave the Wave tells his 34,000 Twitter followers that South Korea blockchain interoperability protocol ICON, better known as ICX, may be gearing up for a parabolic breakout after languishing in bear territory for over 2 years. During that period, ICX wiped out 99% of its value as the coin nosedived from its all-time high of $12.64 to a bear market low of 10 cents. Holy moly. According to CoinMarketCap, talk about getting wrecked. According to Dave, the huge devaluation puts ICX in a position to surge to $102.56 and post astronomical gains of 22,947% in the next bull cycle. If you're bullish on ICX or if it's on your radar, let me know in the comments right down below. Holy moly, could you imagine 22,000% gains? I feel this is going to be a reality, especially during this bull cycle for many of these altcoins, and this may be one of them. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Meanwhile, the crypto trader is updating his Bitcoin roadmap. Dave says that the crypto king has already resolved the large symmetrical triangle that has kept the market bearish for over 2 years. He now expects Bitcoin to launch a vertical ascent to $24,000 in the coming months. Taking a look at his recent tweet, what if? Time to start thinking the end game for this cycle. And I'd love to know your thoughts. Where do you feel the end game for this cycle will be for the Bitcoin price? Do you feel six digits? Let me know your thoughts and predictions in the comments below. He goes on to share, now that the symmetrical triangle has run its course, taken price to the log growth curve, a rise matching the previous with another correction, the length of the previous, which would set up nicely for the home stretch. And based on Dave's chart, as you can see right here on your screen, Bitcoin will likely continue trading inside another triangle until the second quarter of 2021. The breakout from this pattern could ignite a manic phase that would catapult the Bitcoin price to $115,000. Virtually 10x in the current Bitcoin price from where we're at. Now, I don't feel this is so far-fetched to believe, considering the previous halving following it from 2016 to the height of December of 2017, Bitcoin rallied over 4,000%. And for us to reach $100,000, all we need to do is move up 1,000%. Not so far-fetched in the crypto space, to say the least. And before I break down our next story of the day, MicroStrategy, a NASDAQ-listed software firm worth $1.2 billion, bought $250 million in Bitcoin as a reasonable hedge against inflation. First, let's take a look at the overall crypto market. We can see Bitcoin touched at about 11,200 support yesterday, but it did maintain and it rise back a little after retesting that $12,000 critical psychological resistance, which we've been struggling to break. I feel once we can break and retest that 12K, we'll shoot right on up past 13,000 to 14,000, which was last year's high, and continue all the way up to a new all-time high. I predict that will happen this year. What month in particular? I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine. So let me know in the comments right down below. But I still feel uberly bullish on Bitcoin. Just because we witness a pullback doesn't mean that the market is bearish. It could be healthy. That's what I'm talking about. A healthy correction so we could break and blow past that 12K resistance. Ethereum is down 0.8% for the day, trading at $384. Chainlink is surging right now against most of the major cryptos, including Bitcoin and Ethereum, up 12%. Trading at just over $14, probably going to smash $15 here very soon. We have XRP down 3%, trading at 28.5 cents. We have Tezos up 3.5%, trading at $4.25. And now let's actually take a look at the top exchange volume. We can see a sea of green. I love seeing this. It means there's a lot of liquidity and volume pumping into the crypto market. Binance up a whopping 46% with 12.7 billion in volume in the past 24 hours. BitMEX up 6% with 3.6 billion in volume. Hobby Global up 46% with 2.6 billion in volume. And OKEX up 17% with 2.1 billion in volume for the day. And now for three reasons why MicroStrategy adopted Bitcoin and why others will follow. That's right, the CEO of the company just bought 21,454 Bitcoin and calls it digital gold, and the tide will cause the business world to admit the same, says supporters. Let's see if other institutions follow. MicroStrategy has adopted Bitcoin as its reserve currency and stunned commentators by purchasing over 21,000 Bitcoin on August 11th. Holy moly, the world's largest publicly traded business intelligence company has swapped fiat for Bitcoin. Pretty massive news, right? As its treasury reserve asset, but the reasons behind it suggest that more big businesses will have no choice but to do the same. Let's go, institutional demand. Why did MicroStrategy choose Bitcoin, and will others follow? Well, let's talk about it. In a press release issued just yesterday, the CEO, Michael Saylor, went further than most by calling Bitcoin digital gold. With no ifs or buts, Saylor unreservedly plugged the largest crypto over both fiat and other traditional safe haven assets, such as gold. Saylor goes on to share, Bitcoin is digital gold, harder, stronger, faster, and smarter than any money that has preceded it. He commented, and I want to repeat because this is a fact, Bitcoin is digital gold, harder, stronger, faster, and smarter than any money that has preceded it. That angle closely mimics some of Bitcoin's foremost proponents, notably Amos in the book, The Bitcoin Standard, who repeatedly explains that so-called digital scarcity puts Bitcoin in a separate league to any other form of money which has ever existed. Like Amos, Saylor also believes that Bitcoin's very structure will ensure that its value will only increase with time. He added, we expect its value to accrete with advances in technology, expanding adoption, and the network effect that has fueled the rise of so many category killers in the modern era. Now, doubts over fiat's future is the very interesting part about this story, the fact they chose Bitcoin over the dwindling value of the dollar. Bitcoiners were particularly excited about MicroStrategy, as we should be, because it unashamedly replaced fiat currency for crypto. Bitcoin over crypto all day. I can't wait for more publicly traded companies to do the same. Its purchase of 21,454 Bitcoin for an aggregated price of $250 million, that's a quarter billion, folks, late last month, may not only be symbolic given the total 21 million Bitcoin total supply cap, also keep that in mind, but it also means that the company controls 0.1% of the total Bitcoin supply. Let me repeat, the company now controls 0.1% of the total Bitcoin supply, something competitors will find increasingly expensive to replicate. Not many other competitors are going to be able to do the same, especially when Bitcoin starts to soar. Now, MicroStrategy bought 0.1% of the Bitcoin supply. Very few companies will be able to copy this strategy. What Bitcoin Did podcast host Peter McCormick tweeted in his response. And for Saylor, there were multiple red flags that swayed him to turn to Bitcoin. These were, among other things, the economic and public health crisis precipitated by COVID-19, the pandemic, unprecedented government financial stimulus measures, including quantitative easing, printing trillions out of thin air, which adopted around the world, the global political and economic uncertainty, he said. And continuing, he argued that what has began as a result of COVID-19 would only cause further problems later on. Here's what they went on to share. We believe that together, these and other factors may well have a significant depreciating effect on the long-term real value of fiat currencies and many other conventional asset types, including many of the assets traditionally held as part of corporate treasury operations. And Cointelegraph has often reported on the detrimental impact of practices such as quantitative easing and the voices urging consumers to abandon the fiat system en masse to protect their prosperity in the long term. I mean, if they continue printing trillions, it's basic common sense. What do you think is going to happen to the value of the dollar? It's going to eventually collapse and be worthless. So placing your hedge in Bitcoin was a very smart move for this massive company. For Jason Yanowitz, founder of the financial media network Blockworks Group, Saylor's reservations will ultimately spark trailblazing from the entire business sphere. MicroStrategy CEO said they bought Bitcoin to avoid inflation. He summarized, eventually every public company will do the same. I repeat, eventually every public company will do the same. So does that mean MicroStrategy is ahead of their time? I feel so. This was a major chess move. Much respect to MicroStrategy. Finally, Saylor was highly complimentary about Bitcoin in particular and did not mention that the company even considered any other cryptocurrencies. We find the global acceptance, brand recognition, ecosystem vitality, network dominance, architectural resilience, technical utility, and community ethos of Bitcoin to be persuasive evidence of its superiority as an asset class for those seeking a long-term store value. He said, Bitcoin's 11-year lifespan has seen it both remain the largest crypto and fend off multiple concerted efforts to undermine it. As Amos and various others often explain, Bitcoin has proven itself via this method, and alternative cryptos have failed to demonstrate that they can gain Bitcoin status and popularity. Miners' preference for Bitcoin supports the theory that in the long term, security and market prowess will only increase. Bitcoin's technical fundamentals remain in broad uptrend, a result of miners dedicating more and more resources to the network. So as you can see, massive institutional demand, such as MicroStrategy purchasing 21,000 Bitcoin, to add to the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, which has been purchasing more Bitcoin than is actually being mined, which leads us to our next story of the day. Grayscale launches a new crypto ad on national TV, highlighting Bitcoin as well as 8 altcoins. Grayscale's national TV ad that promises to bring crypto to the masses has officially launched. The billion-dollar asset management firm released the 30-second clip on Twitter. The commercial highlights the massive money printing of central banks and pitfalls of paper money to compel people to invest in digital assets. The ad will be featured on CNBC, MSNBC, Fox, as well as Fox Business. The end of the commercial lists Grayscale's 9 crypto products, which offer exposure to Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP, Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, Stellar Lumens, Ethereum Classic, as well as Zcash and Horizon, better known as Zen. Let's take a look at the actual commercial and let me know what you think.
Before money, people traded goods, tools, cattle, grain, even shells represented value. Then currency came along. They made it out of copper, gold, silver, wampum. Soon people decided to put all that value into a piece of paper, then proceeded to wave goodbye to value, printing unlimited amounts of money as they passed the buck to the future. That's why it's time for digital currency and your investment in the Grayscale funds. Go digital, go Grayscale.
Pretty cool, right? Now, if this doesn't drive massive demand to the industry, I don't know what will. I just love the fact it's national TV coverage. Although this video has hit 76,000 views, 2,200 likes, and 1,000 retweets at the time of publishing, some members of the cryptoverse are not impressed. One user pointed out that the ad spent most of its airtime talking about the history of currency and money while giving limited exposure to Grayscale's products. Another crypto enthusiast is disappointed that the commercial's narrator failed to mention Bitcoin by name. John Miles, who tweeted, I can't believe you spent spent that much money, didn't say Bitcoin, and actually listed Bitcoin Cash and Ethereum Classic, which is currently under centralized attack in this ad. I was hyped for this, and I must say it was a disappointment. And then he goes on to share, this ad is a case against unlimited currency, and we don't know how much ether there is. Don't buy into unlimited paper currency. Here, have some unlimited digital currency, XRP. Come on, people. He actually makes a great point. Instead of just focusing on Bitcoin itself, the Grayscale Trust does focus on 8 cryptocurrencies. Let me know if you agree with John Miles or if you feel he's being too hypercritical here. Grayscale's new commercial is the second biggest advertising push from the leading digital asset investment firm. Grayscale released 2 ads in succession last year comparing Bitcoin to gold. And just in case you missed it, check it out. Drop gold commercial from Grayscale.
Why did you invest in gold? Are you living in the past? In a digital world, gold shouldn't weigh down your portfolio. You see where things are going. Digital currencies like Bitcoin are the future. They're secure, borderless, and unlike gold, they actually have utility. Leave the pack behind. It's time to drop gold. Go digital. Go Grayscale.
Let me know your thoughts surrounding this 30-second drop gold commercial. And before I break down our next story of the day, this new crypto asset skyrockets 1,880% on launch day. First, let's take a look at the overall crypto market cap, sitting at $351 billion with $111 billion in volume in the past 24 hours. And the current BTC dominance is 60.2%. Also, keep in mind, if we exclude stablecoins and ICO, the realized market cap slash Bitcoin dominance is closer to 80%. And now taking a look at the top gainers within the top 100 within the past 24 hours, we have Compound soaring in the DeFi space once again, up 40%, trading at $233. We have Aragon up 33%, trading at $5.37. We have IrisNet up 33%, trading at 12 cents. Ample Fourth up 27%, trading at 87 cents. Maker up almost 27%, trading at $777. And Synthetics Network up 19%, trading at $5.47. So as you can see, most of the coins surging right now are actually in the decentralized finance space. And taking a look at the biggest losers in the top 100 in the past 24 hours, Yearn Finance is down 8.9%, trading now at $5,600. We have Hedera Hashgraph down 7%, trading at 5 cents. Divi down 7%, trading at 7 cents. Zilliqa down 7%, trading at 2.5 cents. Flexicoin down 7%, trading at 0.004, and IOTA down 6%, trading at 36 cents. Which altcoins in particular are you most bullish on? Let me know in the comments right down below. And now checking out the BitMEX margins, we can see the bears are back in control, leading with almost 80 million in superiority in the last 24 hours, with shorts leading 51.4% versus 48.5% longs. Are you currently bullish or bearish on the king of all crypto? Let me know in the comments right down below. And now checking out one of my favorite indicators, because it's typically right on point. For example, yesterday we were in extreme greed, which hints there's going to be a correction. And what did we witness? A major correction. So that's why I love sharing with you the crypto greed and fear index shows we're currently rated a 75 in greed. And if you're not familiar with the crypto greed and fear index, extreme fear can be a sign investors are too worried. That can be a buying opportunity. BTFD, buy the dip. And when investors are getting too greedy, that means the market is due for a correction like we're witnessing right now. And before I break down our final story of the day and share with you this new crypto asset, which skyrocketed 1,880% on launch day, first, I want to remind you to smash the show more button right below this video in the description for a detailed analysis of what's going on in the market. This goes for all 500 plus videos right here on my channel. Also, I have some very helpful resources for you to plug into, including the blog to my podcast, which could be found at cryptonewsyes.com. Also, be sure to subscribe on YouTube by smashing that subscribe button right below this video in the description, or you can visit the direct link, which is cryptonewsalerts.net. You can also find us on all the major podcasting platforms, including Apple's iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, and Stitcher Radio. Also, be sure to follow us on Twitter to receive daily crypto news alerts. My Twitter handle is cryptonewsyes. And for those of you active on Facebook, as I am, I do have a crypto Facebook group entitled Crypto Alchemy with over 17,000 strong from all over the world. To become a part of it, simply click this link, request to join. I'll be sure to plug you in. And for those of you active on Telegram, as I am, I do have a crypto Telegram chat. To join it, click this link. You'll automatically be added, and I'm looking forward to connecting with you personally on the inside. All right, now let's break down our final story of the day, shall we? A new crypto asset is taking the cryptoverse by storm after surging 1,880% on launch day. Welcome to crypto, my friend. Serum, better known as SRM, a new crypto that will act as both the utility and governance token of the soon-to-be-launched decentralized derivatives exchange, Serum, jumped from 10 cents to as high as $1.98 after launching, according to CoinGecko. At this time, the crypto token is trading at $1.86. If you're bullish on SRM, or if you're watching it and it's on your radar, let me know in the comments right down below. Project Serum bills itself as the antidote to many weaknesses that plague decentralized finance protocols, including the lack of liquidity, slow processing speed, and the inability to facilitate cross-chain transactions. The project has quickly gained a lot of attention thanks to its leader, Sam Bankman-Fried, founder of the crypto derivatives exchange, FTX, and Alameda Research. He says the decentralized exchange will give users the experience they're using to enjoy the centralized exchanges. Here's what he goes on to share. Serum is fast and it's cheap and powerful and fully cross-chain compatible, and it's truly fully trustless. Serum is built on the Solana blockchain. Solana can process 10,000 times as much as Ethereum, and it's 1 million times cheaper. And unlike any sidechains, Solana is a fully fledged decentralized blockchain with over 100 validators. Also want to mention, if you haven't realized it, the Ethereum blockchain has been pretty clogged. I went to send like $40 the other day to make a purchase, and the transaction fee for gas was close to $60, and I couldn't believe it, but that's what's happening. So competitors like this allows Serum to have full central order limit books with the familiar market limit and IOC orders, processing multiple times per second, all while being fully on chain. This is then combined with the powerful cross-chain protocol, allowing for trustless and efficient tokenization and swaps, meaning that while living natively on Solana, Serum is interoperable on Ethereum. SRM holders will get discounts on trading fees and can be staked power to the protocol. Bankman-Fried says that Serum Exchange will launch in the coming weeks, so we'll be keeping an eye out here at Crypto News Alerts. Let me know your thoughts surrounding this particular altcoin, Serum. Are you watching it? Are you hodling? Are you holding? Is it on your radar? Drop me a comment right down below. I'm just looking forward for you experiencing 2,000 to 20,000% gains because, hey, it's happening and this crypto bull run is just getting started, my friend. Well, that's going to conclude today's show. As always, I appreciate you tuning in and journeying along with me inside this incredible crypto matrix. If you gain value out of today's show, be sure to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts just like this every single day. And real quick before I go, if interested in tapping into OPM and leveraging other people's money to grow your wealth and crypto portfolio, smash the link right below this video in the description and register for this free system entitled OPM Wealth. You'll be glad you did, and I look forward to seeing you on tomorrow's episode. Peace.